Rafael, welcome to Melbourne. Thanks so much for being here. It's a real pleasure to have you, in Melbourne and back in Australia. Of course, we're here to launch the Babolat Pure Aero Play tennis racket. You've been using it since December. It's the first time it's been available in Australia, and the 15 people in this room are the first people in Australia to have purchased the racket, and they're the first ones to have played with it. So, real treat for them.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. Thank you.
Before we get into talking about the racket, a lot of the people out there are tennis players. They play at their local club, in their local community. Can you remember what it was like when you were growing up in Mallorca, playing at the first club on clay? And do you ever go back there now? And what sort of reception do you get when you go back to the first club that you started playing at as a junior?
Well, I started in the Manacor Tennis Club. It's the tennis club of my small village. And yes, well, I started there when I had 3 years old because my uncle was the coach of the club. And yeah, we came back there very often, no? But by the way, until 3 years ago, we were practicing there the most of the time, no? So just the good thing is I don't have a big, you know, the people don't get something special when I'm there because I am there very often, no? I never went. So it's like I go to a normal place when I go there, for everybody.
Yeah, fantastic. It's not the same for us when you're here. So 14 times you've bitten a Grand Slam trophy. Mm. We're all hoping that it's 15 at the Australian Open this year. What's your preparation been like, and how are you feeling coming into the first Slam of the year?
Good, great. No, I had a very good preparation, I think. I practiced a lot, and I feel ready to go. Then anything can happen on the competition, but for the moment I think I practiced enough, and I'm very well, so let's see how it goes now.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, of course, we are here to launch the Babolat Pure Aero Play racket. It's been racket designed for you. How much say did you have in it? What sort of, how many test rackets did you go through? Do you get involved in the intricacies of the weight and the balance points and that sort of thing? How involved were you in the making of this new racket?
Well, always we work together with Babolat on the new things, no? And you know, Babolat always is close to the players to look for the things that the players are demanding. Always, sometimes more spin, sometimes more power, sometimes more control. For everybody is different, but for me personally, I like a racket with the racket that has power, the racket that has a lot of spin. And that's what we're looking for this new racket, and I think is a great racket, and I hope gonna help a lot of people.
Yeah, for sure. And the technology that's in it, it's revolutionary. It's Babolat. It's unique to Babolat in the world. The play technology. Does Tony use it in your coaching sessions? Does he have his iPhone there looking at the statistics? Rafa hit with more spin, hit the ball harder. Is he telling you those sort of things? Is he using play?
Not during the practices, no. No, he has all the data then, and he's looking not every single day, because then you get crazy, but it's good to have all this information during these different periods of time of the year, no? Because you can compare and you can check when you are hitting with more topspin, less topspin, where you are hitting the ball. You know, all these things that helps the coaches to say, okay, Rafa, now you are doing that, or you were doing that when you were playing better, or you are doing now that you are playing worse, so we need to come back to another thing. That's good help for the coaches, 100%.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, Rafa, thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Best of luck at the Aussie.
I need
you
it.
Go all the way and take it out.
Thank you very much.